I like that phrase, boomerang Londoners. I can imagine that there might be some mayors here in the United States who might take that first word and use it for themselves.
There's another phrase, Jonathan, which you'll appreciate. As speaking as a parent of a children who grow up, there are boomerang children. They return home as well.
I like that. I'm writing all of these things down, and you're a gold mine of great phrases. One of the things that you are most known for is for being a vocal leader on climate change and sustainability. I want to let the viewers know, particularly here in the United States, that earlier today in London, you were announced as the next global chair of C40 Cities, which is a network of nearly 100 cities, 100 of the world's leading cities that have committed to tackling climate change. You don't formally assume the role until the chairmanship, until I think it's December 1st. What are your plans once you do? And if you could, talk about the importance of C40.
Well, thank you for mentioning that. I mean, the key thing we've got to get across is across the globe is climate change isn't something that affects us in 10, 20, 30 years' time, or only affects those people in sub-Saharan Africa or in South Asia. It's happening now, the consequences of climate change. You've seen it in the awful floods in New York. You saw the loss of life there, in the wildfires and so forth taking place across the globe from Greece to Australia. We saw it in London, flash flooding this summer, which meant a lot of our tube stations were closed down, many, many homes flooded. In Germany, you've seen the awful fires taking place there. So it's happening now. And one of the things we also know, you and I both are good examples of this, is most of the world's population live in our cities. But the way COP26 works is it's national governments reaching an agreement how they can reduce their greenhouse emissions. The reality is, though, the only way we're going to be successful at fighting climate change and deal with the other twin challenge of air pollution is by cities be given the powers and funding they need to bring about meaningful change. And I'm incredibly proud to be the next chair of C40, taking over from my good friend, the mayor of Los Angeles, Eric Garcetti. We represent almost 100 cities across the globe with a population north of 700 million. And we are responsible, I'm proud to say, for more than a quarter of global wealth. So we're really important. And the great news about C40 is this is a global group of networks coming together. We're saying we want to have bold policies to address the twin challenges of climate change to get to zero carbon as soon as possible in London. Our aim is net zero carbon by 2030, but also air pollution. We want to get to zero pollution as soon as possible as well, because we don't talk much about air pollution. This is an invisible killer leading to premature deaths, leading to children having stunted lungs forever, and adults with a whole host of health issues from asthma to dementia to cancer to heart disease. And it's really important that we lobby our governments to make sure COP26 in just a couple of weeks' time is a success.